Thank you. Dear Austin and Alicia, we love you. We're so proud of both of you and know that we're going to have a happy marriage together, and you are perfect for each other. God has really put each other, each one of you, in each other's path, and we just love you.
Hey, Austin and Alicia, so thankful for the two of you and finally in marriage, and can't wait to see what God's got in store for your lives. We're so excited. Love you guys so much. And just may God richly bless you forever. We love you.
Love you.
Alicia and Austin, we hope you had a wonderful day. We enjoyed being here to celebrate you with you all. And advice for the future, treat each other as sweetly and kindly as you did while you were dating, and you will enjoy your years together in the future.
Whatever you got her with, keep that going. That'll keep her around for the rest of your life. Whatever you did, whatever you said, however you acted.
Exactly. Continue to be sweet. Don't change.
Dear Austin and Alicia, we're so happy for you on your wedding day. It's an honor, Alicia, to have you as my little sister. It was an honor to be your teacher years ago in high school and watch you grow up and how you love the Lord. We're so thankful for how the Lord has led you to Austin. And Austin, we're very thankful that the Lord has given our little sister a dear husband, and we're thankful to have you as our brother-in-law. We wish you God's best and that He will give you many years together of serving the Lord.
You may be seated. On behalf of the bride and groom, I would like to welcome you today. We come together today to witness the marriage of my little sister, Alicia, to Austin. A Christian marriage is more than just a formal ceremony recognizing a legal bond. It is an institution ordained by God to join one man and one woman. The original marriage took place in the Garden of Eden as God Himself joined Adam and Eve. God had created a wonderful place of great beauty. In fact, it was a perfect place. And God stepped back and looked at all that He created, and He declared it to be very good. But there was one thing that was not good. And we read in Genesis 2, verse 18, "And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a help meet for him." And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs, and he closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh." God created the spouse for Adam with the intention that the two cleave to each other, that they become one flesh. As some people search for God's will for a spouse, they wish that God would just drop that perfect someone right down from heaven. But Adam had it even better. He had a custom-built bride made by the hand of God himself. And life was certainly sweet for the newlyweds. They had a perfect place to live, the perfect spouse. Surely nothing could mess this up. But just one chapter later, in Genesis 3, we read that they disobeyed God and sin came into their perfect world, and they lost everything. They lost their relationship with God. As a holy God, he cannot tolerate fellowship with defiled, sinful man. They lost their perfect relationship with each other. The first thing we hear Adam do after he sinned was blame his wife for his sin. All was lost. And it was not only lost for Adam and Eve. All men that came after Adam, that come after Adam and Eve, are sinners. We read in Romans 5, verse 12, "Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned." In Romans 3, 23, we read, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." And so what was lost in the garden was lost for us all. We are all sinners, and this affects our daily lives. Sin separates us from God and men. Sin destroys relationships. And there is perhaps no clearer evidence of the results of sin today than the destruction of the marriage and the home. Sin destroys what God intended to be good. But almost as soon as man sinned against God, God announced a plan to restore all that was lost. And the answer to the problem of sin is love. When we hear the word love, several things might come to our minds. An emotional attachment or a physical attraction is how many would define love. Some go a little bit further, a step deeper, and speak of love in terms of unity through common likes and goals. But when I speak of love as the answer to the problem of sin, I speak of a love beyond all love. A divine love. We read in John, in 1 John 4, verse 10, "Herein is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be a propitiation for our sins." Because of our sin, we deserve to be punished. The Bible declares that the ultimate payment of sin to be death. But God loved us. And this divine love of God is his answer for everything that was lost in the garden. His Son paid the punishment for our sins on the cross. That is real sacrificial love. In Ephesians 5, verse 1, we read, "Walk in love, as Christ also has loved us and has given himself for us." And the Bible uses this picture of perfect love to teach us how a man and a woman can live a life of love for each other. The chapter goes on and explains how we can walk in the love of Christ. And Alicia and Austin, the example of true love Christ has given us is the ultimate sacrifice. As there was no selfishness involved in Christ's sacrifice for us, there is no place for selfishness in a marriage. Alicia, the way this passage teaches you to love Austin sacrificially is that you submit to him as your head. We read in Ephesians 5, verse 22, right after we have read to walk in love as Christ loved us, we read, "Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their husbands in everything." This picture of the church's submission to Christ is not a picture of a slave submitting to an overbearing master. It is a picture of people that are saved through the sacrificial act of Christ. And their response to this loving sacrifice is ultimate submission. And God speaks in this passage that walking in love as a wife means making the sacrifice of submitting to your husband that God has given you. Many in this world would see this teaching to be old-fashioned and perhaps even overbearing. But they fail to see that the instruction in this passage to the man is even more intense. You see, the church submits to a Christ that shows ultimate and complete sacrifice. Ultimate and complete love. And so the teaching of submission here is not a forced obedience to a dictator, but a natural response to the selfless love of the husband. And Austin, the way this passage teaches you to walk in love as Christ did is to have a humble, loving, sacrificial attitude of Christ in your relationship to Alicia. We read in Ephesians 5, verse 25, "Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might be sanctified and cleanse, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word." Austin, we as men are required to willingly make a great sacrifice and to hold nothing back for ourselves. Christ's act had one purpose: to give us back what we all lost in the garden. To sanctify and cleanse that which was defiled. The goal of his sacrifice was a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. And Austin, your sacrificial love for Alicia should have the same goal. That she, because of your relationship to her, becomes even more holy and more like Christ. Christ loved the church so much and desired to sanctify the church so much that he was willing to make the ultimate sacrifice. And God's word calls husbands to have that kind of love for their wives. Look at the love of Christ as he hung on the cross for your sins. And let that be a daily example for your role as a husband in marriage. The picture of love here is not that you love because you are loved. It is not based on anything that Alicia has done to gain your love. The love with which we as men are to love our wives is an unconditional, self-sacrificing love for the sake of our spouse. We all lost, with Adam and Eve in the garden, the ability to have a perfect relationship. But God provides us with the remedy for that which we lost. Look at the cross. See the love of Christ and emulate his love for you every day in your marriage. And when you do this, then your marriage will be pleasing to Christ. It will be a marriage that makes both of you more like Christ. And your home will be a place of unity and peace that brings God glory, because you are walking in self-sacrificing, Christ-like love. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for your guidance. We thank you for the work you have done, first in saving Alicia and Austin from their sins. We thank you, Lord, for the way you have led them in their walk with you and how you have led them to walk in their love for you and for one another together. We thank you for this day that you have led them to, and pray, Lord, that you would bless this ceremony so that you receive the glory for everything that is said and done here. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I. You, Austin, and you, Alicia, now come to be united in this rite of marriage, which is the first and oldest rite in the world, instituted by God Himself, and the first marriage was performed by Him. And now I solemnly charge you to remember that it's just that commitment of self to each other which God expects you in making these pledges, which each of you will now enter into. Now, Austin, to the husband, though Scripture says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave Himself for it, that He might present it to Himself a glorious church, not having spot nor wrinkle or any such thing, that it should be holy and without blemish, so ought men to love their wives. And Alicia, to the wife, the Scripture says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and He is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. And to you both, the Scriptures say, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Austin, do you take Alicia to be your wedded wife, promising to keep, cherish, and protect her, and to be faithful and true husband so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Alicia, do you take Austin to be your wedded husband, promising to love, honor, and obey him, and be a faithful and true wife so long as you both shall live?
I do.
I would then ask you to face each other and join hands. and repeat after me. I, Austin, take you, Alicia.
I, Austin, take you, Alicia.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
With joy I receive you.
With joy I receive you.
Unto my life together we may be one.
Unto my life together we may be one.
As Christ is to the church, so will I be to you.
As Christ is to the church, so will I be to you.
A loving and faithful husband.
A loving and faithful husband.
Leading you as Christ leads you.
Leading you as Christ leads you.
I promise you my deepest love.
I promise you my deepest love.
Fullest devotion and tender care.
Fullest devotion and tender care.
As I live first unto God, I promise that I will lead our lives.
As I live first unto God, I promise that I will lead our lives.
Unto a life of faith and hope.
Unto a life of faith and hope.
In Christ.
In Christ.
Ever honoring.
Ever honoring.
God's guidance by His Spirit.
God's guidance by His Spirit.
Through the Word.
Through the Word.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joys and in sorrows.
In joys and in sorrows.
Until death do we part.
Until death do we part.
I pledge to you my life.
I pledge to you my life.
As a loving and faithful husband.
As a loving and faithful husband.
Now, Alicia, as you continue to hold hands, repeat after me. I, Alicia, take you, Austin.
I, Alicia, take you, Austin.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
With joy come into my life with you.
With joy I come into my life with you.
As you have pledged to me your life and love.
As you have pledged to me your life and love.
So I do give you my life.
So I do give you my life.
In confidence submitting myself to your headship.
In confidence submitting myself to your headship.
As to the Lord.
As to the Lord.
As in the church in her relationship to Christ.
As in the church in her relationship to Christ.
So I will be to you.
So I will be to you.
I will live first unto our God.
I will live first unto our God.
And then you.
And then you.
Loving you, obeying you.
Loving you, obeying you.
Caring for you and ever seeking to please you.
Caring for you and ever seeking to please you.
God hath prepared me for you.
God has prepared me for you.
And so I will ever strengthen.
And so I will ever strengthen.
Help, comfort, and encourage you.
Help, comfort, and encourage you.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joys and sorrows.
In joys and sorrows.
Until death do we part.
Until death do we part.
I pledge to you my life.
I pledge to you my life.
As an obedient and faithful wife.
As an obedient and faithful wife.
Austin, what token of your love do you give?
The ring. This ring.
These rings are gold and are precious. So let your love be the most cherished earthly possession. These rings are a perfect and unbroken circle, the symbol of eternity. So may your love be to all eternity. With these emblems of purity and endless devotion, showing how lasting and imperishable is the faith now mutually pledged you to each other, and these marriage vows do you here and now forever seal. Austin, take this ring and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And all my worldly goods.
And all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
And Alicia, what token do you give?
A ring.
Take this ring, place it on Austin's hand, and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And all my worldly goods.
And all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Was not there. together from it, as you promised. And Lord, as we promised, I pray that we would live for you, Lord, and seek your guidance for our lives. God, just thank you for bringing us together. I love Alicia so much. Pray that you would bless our life as a marriage and as a union, Lord. I pray that we would glorify you, Lord. Bring you glory with our decisions. God, thank you for giving us the strength. Lord, I pray that we would live for you, Lord. And that people would see you through us. God, thank you for being our Father. Thank you for our love. I pray these things in your name. Amen.
Charity, which is the bond of perfectness. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Guys, these are our babies. And it's
it's okay, buddy.
Let's pray. Sometimes words just don't come. Father, you're so good to us. Father, I don't understand how you can love man like you love us. Lord, the price you gave to bring us back. Together. Lord, I thank you for this young couple here. always be each need. Lord, as the journey goes on, sometimes there's potholes in the road, sometimes the road's smooth, sometimes, Lord, there's a mountain real high to climb. And I'm thankful you're always there, Father, to guide each step. And Lord, please be with him in their careers, in their life, in the families they'll have, the decisions they'll make. I pray, Lord, that you'll be at the center of each and every step of the way. Father, please just bless them richly. Lord, may your precious hand guide me. Lord, I'm so thankful that they both know you as Lord and Savior. I'm so thankful knowing, Lord, that they'll trust you and put every ounce of faith they have in you for every decision. And Lord, may they rest and make each decision on your precious word. But Lord, guide them now. Help them. Bless them. Lord, may your will and way be done in their lives. And I want to thank you especially for an answer prayer. I thank you for a God that does answer prayer. Alicia's an answer prayer. I prayed many years for a good Christian girl for Austin. And Lord, you answered. Thank you. Bless them richly. Thank you. And we're careful always to give you the glory and the praise.
We now come to the part of the service that is the final and most important. Marriage is a covenant between a man and a woman and God. It cannot be tainted by human emotions. So we would ask that when I pronounce them husband and wife, do not clap. Instead, maybe a hearty amen or praise the Lord. But it makes it so much more sacred, and that's what it is. Austin Alicia, by the authority conferred on me as an ordained pastor and by the laws of the state of Georgia, I pronounce you husband and wife. That which God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Austin Cox. Amen.
Come on,
no. Attention, everyone. We have Alicia and Austin. Todd,
your side. Yeah. Remember your mother made that? Or you made that, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Beautiful. Okay, baby.
So we go ahead and cut it.
Okay. Yeah. Hold on.
Mm-hmm.
Is it here? Mm-hmm. You click for me?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, watch out. It's okay.
Just trying to get the spoon.
Okay. It's all good. It's fine. All right. Yeah. Okay. Feed me first.
Yeah. Our hands?
Yeah, hold on. Okay. Hold on, hold on. Okay.
Be nice.
Aww. You're not nice.
Why are
they coffee? Coffee.
Coffee.
Lauren, let's go get our coffee, please.
Yep, you're gonna need that one.
Oh.
Is it gonna be too hot for you guys to actually drink? Can you just give me 10?
Okay. Yeah. Yes, cake. I got it.
Yeah. Okay. It's so pretty.
I didn't know how it would go out.
No, no, it's gorgeous. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tastes good too.
Mm-hmm.
It up, and then you just get it close. We need the cake server.
No, it's fine.
It's good. Okay. I'm gonna put it in my own mouth. Okay.
That's really good.
Never met that.
Both are really good. We're going to have to... No, no, baby. Good luck. I think you're on the wrong side. Over here.
How does this work? Oh.
Okay. We're going to lock arms if we can do this. Actually, let's just do this first. Let's just take pictures this way.
Okay.
It's kind of hard to do right now. Can you put your up there? Okay. Oh. All right. Okay.
Congratulations, I hope you guys had a wonderful day. And if I was gonna leave any advice, Alicia, I get your names mixed up all the time. Alicia, get a good firing pan for you to smack Austin over the head when he's bad boy. And Austin, keep her in line. I love you.